Fifth Quarter Extra, Fridays at 11:35 on Fox 10.
Greetings, friends, and welcome to Fifth Quarter Extra, presented by the Urs Automotive Group. I'm Joe Bricado, soon to be joined by Ben Eschenbaugh. More highlights from around the state and into Ohio coming your way in our next segment. Bob Huggins and his Mountaineers taking the court at the Coliseum for their preseason intra-squad scrimmage. We'll take a look ahead to week number 9, and Ben will check in with Lewis County 2 sports standout Riley Gunter. But we begin with our live in-studio head coach, guest Brad Jett from the South Harrison Hawks. 28-0 victors over Webster County this evening in Lost Creek. Coach, congratulations on the victory. 7-0 lead at the half, and then you get contributions from a lot of different guys in the second half. What started to work for you in the second?
Well, we've been playing defense real well all year. And going in at halftime, up 7-0, we had to make a few offensive line adjustments and work with our backfield. Right now we're shuffling a lot of kids trying to keep fresh legs and give the young ones a break. And what we had the adjustment, plus we had a short field most of the second half. Webster did a good job of taking care of the football the first half, but the second half they had a couple turnovers and we had a couple short drives that we turned into points, and that helps. We had a couple turnovers tonight that really didn't hurt us, but anytime you lay the ball down it does, and they had a couple. They had a bad snap on a punt, and we had another short field to where we could put it in, and the kids have just played hard. We're tickled to death with where we're at right now.
Third victory by shutout. Defensively, what was working for you tonight, and how impressed are you with how the guys have played defense, not just tonight, but all throughout the year?
Well, our defensive coaching staff, our defensive coordinator, Mark Clayton, does an excellent job preparing the young men. And then you get Frank Tate, our defensive line coach, Chris Underwood, our defensive end coach, Mark Jones, our secondary coach, and Coach Clayton coaches the linebackers. And they just prepare the kids great for the upcoming week. And this group's very coachable, and they line up where they're supposed to be, and they just get after it.
Tough game against Tyler Consolidated last week. You guys fall 6-0, but as you've done in your previous games, you bounce back from losses, just as you did in week 2 against Gilmer County, just as you did in week 4 against the Lincoln Cougars. How are you able to get the kids refocused for this game?
Well, like I said, this group's something special. We've been very blessed with the young men we have this year. After everything that's happened to us in the past, this group's come in, been very coachable, have made no excuses, and they go out and they just play hard. And that's the biggest thing that I'm tickled to death with them. Our coaching staff's worked extremely hard to prepare them, and they've just went out and done what we've asked them to do.
When we talked in the preseason, you'd made a special point that conditioning was going to have to be important for this group because you didn't necessarily have depth at a lot of positions. How are you 7 games into the season now? How are you pleased with the way that you guys have been able to rotate in some younger?
Well, what I'm really tickled about right now, we've only had really one season in ending injury to this point right now. We have a broken collarbone from a freshman back that really did an excellent job for us, and we miss him. But right now we're the healthiest we've been in probably 5 years, and I think that goes with our out-of-season strength program and conditioning, plus our kids are younger. Our young men are older than what they've been. We have a small senior class, but we have a large junior class, small sophomore class, and our freshmen. Coach Barnett always told me, for as many sophomores as you play, that's how many games you lose. Well, I wish he was around so I could ask him, because we're playing 4 freshmen. I'd like to know how many games we're supposed to lose with 4 freshmen on the field.
Not a large senior class, as you mentioned, but their contributions and what they've meant to you personally throughout the years in the program.
Great leadership this year. They're stepping it up, and they're leading by example. They're playing hard. They're giving us everything they got, and our goal is to win every down, and they're trying to do that. We've stubbed our toe. We've hurt ourselves in our 3 losses, and last week was extremely hard. We told them how proud we were of them because they didn't quit. The ball rolls in the end zone, and they're fortunate enough to fall on it. And it doesn't always go your way, but to bounce back and play hard And, you know, we were only up 7-0. We could have very easily been up 14-0. We turned it over inside the 10 and laid it on the ground. But just to be coached and to play hard like they do is great for our community and great for their parents that they've raised the children that way.
So we talked about some of the older guys. You work in some younger guys, too. And it's obviously difficult for freshmen to come in and contribute right away, but how have some of those younger guys been able to step in and contribute?
Well, you know, right now on defense, we're starting two seniors right now. We're starting Cody Roy, defensive end, and Kyle Stickle, the linebacker, our Will linebacker. And everybody else is underclassmen. And right now in our backfield, there's not a senior in our backfield. They're all underclassmen. We've got three offensive linemen that are seniors, four offensive linemen that are seeing playing time that are seniors that, are leading by example. I mean, they go out and practice hard and play hard. And you can't ask for any more than that. A school our size, our community's always backed us. They've always been there for the student athletes. And, you know, this is something just well deserved for this group of kids.
With the amount of younger players that you're able to work in at this point, and being 4-3, do you get the sense that the arrow is starting to point back upwards and you're getting closer to where you want to be?
Nowadays, you can't. I mean, from my standpoint, after 31 years, you live for the moment. You praise the children you have and you go on. You don't know what the next day is going to bring. And, I mean, we showed up Friday, and one of our starters had a temperature 102. We didn't have him Friday night. And, I mean, you got to go. Larger schools just plug somebody else in and go with it. And single way, you kind of do some shuffling, and you may have to shuffle 3 or 4. So you can't count your eggs and put them all in one basket. You just, plug away and get them all back out, keep them all healthy, and see what happens.
Tough challenge next week with St. Mary's coming in your final home game, and then you got Payton City and Ward County to close out the season. A chance that you guys could get to 6-7 victories, maybe possibly get back into postseason play. I know you want to take every game one game at a time, but is there a chance that this club can get back into postseason play or at least very close?
Well, going in, we didn't know really what we had. We knew we had a bunch of young kids mixed in with some older kids that practiced extremely hard and did everything we tried to get in them to do. I really believe once everything starts clicking that, it may be this season. It may not be till next season. I don't know. We're going to take and play and try to win every down of every game. That's our goal, is to win every snap. And, St. Mary's is coming in. They're extremely well coached. They're well disciplined. I drove down and watched them play Tyler. We'll trade film with them tomorrow. And, they'll come in and they're going to give us a real good look of where we need to be. And I'm not going to sell our student athletes short. I'm sure they're going to step up and we'll see what happens. I mean, about 4 years ago, they came in here and ranked fourth and they didn't leave happy. So, that's why you play the game. Somebody forgot to tell Mississippi State that they weren't supposed to win in the SEC. So we'll just see what happens.
That is South Harrison head coach Brad Jett. His Hawks improving to 4-3 after a 28-0 victory over Webster County tonight. Coach, very much appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Best of luck the rest of the way, and we'll see what the Hawks can do the rest of the way.
Thank you, sir.
Coming up after the break, four more sets of highlights from Inwood, Oak Hill, Weirton, and Frontier, Ohio. Plus, we'll take you to the Coliseum for the WVU Gold Blue Scrimmage as Fifth Quarter Extra, presented by the Urus Automotive Group, continues.